Senanayake Kumarathunga, Honorable Minister Vijayadasa Rajapaksa, Honorable H.M. Fauzi, the High Commissioner for South Africa in Sri Lanka, ambassadors and members of the diplomatic corps, members representing the cricket team for South Africa, ladies and gentlemen, sons and daughters, friends. It is my honor and pleasant duty to be here and speak a few words today in memory of one of the foremost human beings of our time, the late Nelson Mandela. A natural leader from childhood, he wore many hats at various stages of his life. The flamboyant young lawyer, the human rights activist, the aristocrat, the peacemaker, the politician, and not least, the elder statesman. Were some of these roles that he eased into naturally. He was guided into such roles due to the strength of his beliefs and convictions, which he adhered to at all times, both stubbornly and admirably. Being an educated child of illiterate parents, he envisioned the great advantage of a fully literate South Africa, prompting him to comment, and I quote, "Education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world." South Africa owes to him an unrepayable debt. In him being the major catalyst that transformed an apartheid-riddled country and government from racism to a fully representative democracy. He said, and I quote, "To deny people of their human rights is to challenge their very humanity. And I detest racism because I regard it as barbaric, whether it comes from a black man or a white man." As the president of South Africa, he acquired a father figure-like status in global politics. To leaders and countries the world over, he became the greatest and noblest export of South Africa to the world at large. He is the modern benchmark of what it takes to be a statesman. This is why we honor him in Sri Lanka today, just as much as his good name is being celebrated and felicitated. During this time, across the globe, to mark the United Nations Nelson Mandela Day. His capacity to forgive was exemplary, and the forgiveness he demonstrated to even those that hounded and humiliated him and made him endure physical and psychological torture during the long years of incarceration as a political prisoner amply emphasizes this. Even in the office of president, he was known to have lived simply. The Truth and Reconciliation Commission set up in South Africa under President Mandela's guidance was a great stepping stone in the direction of reparations and rehabilitation, as much as bringing closure to the victims. Sri Lanka too could have built on a similar model in dealing with the post-conflict issues that have arisen in this country, in which case I believe this government would have found implementation much easier. I like to conclude with yet another pearl from the great Mandela, in which he articulates his vision for his country, and I quote, "If there are dreams about a beautiful South Africa, there are also roads to lead to their goal. Two of these roads can be named as goodness and forgiveness." I thank you.
Thank you.